just nice bed.
Gotta be in a little bit longer.
I mean, you need that furry jacket though.
Yeah, I do.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Just gotta get the last one.
Yes.
I think the impact was about right here behind you, Scott.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I need for that.
You good to go?
Yeah, a little bit.
No.
It's marked at the top right here.
There is the code. So we can...
That wouldn't make sense.
Hmm?
Because if his gouge mark starts right here.
Got it.
driver's rear. Oh! Oh!
Eric, E-R-I-K, Burse, B-U-R-S-E.
And your title?
Sergeant, Texas Highway Patrol.
Okay, now if you could just recap what happens out here.
Well, we responded to a two-vehicle crash in Montgomery County on State Highway 105 and Willis-Waukegan. We had one vehicle traveling east on State Highway 105 and another traveling westbound. Unfortunately, one of the vehicles went into a skid after it hit an icy patch on a roadway. That vehicle goes into a side skid and is struck by the other vehicle traveling westbound. The driver in the pickup truck that was traveling eastbound did not survive the crash.
So we just have one fatality here?
We have one fatality, that's correct.
Any other injuries?
The driver of the sport utility vehicle did suffer minor injuries to his leg and head, but he was not transported and he was released.
Seeing something like this, the aftermath of a crash of this caliber, I mean, is it just kind of a miracle that the other driver survived?
Yeah, it's a miracle that he survived. Yeah, it's unfortunate that we had one that didn't survive. You know, we're constantly out here trying to get everybody to understand the dangers that pose on a road, that pose against a roadway when we have ice on it.
And now, so the cause of this accident, of course, was the weather. Do we believe any other, maybe alcohol or drugs, nothing else related to this?
The accident is still under investigation, but the preliminary investigation does lead to unsafe speed due to the road conditions.
Mm-hmm. And I guess that's the main message that we want to get out here while we're all out here today. We're trying to tell everybody the best thing to do is to stay home to avoid things like this. Is there anything that you want to just let the people at home know about that?
That is correct. If you can stay at home, please stay at home. If you do have to get out and travel on the roadway, check with the road, check with your news media, check with your social media, make sure that the roadways are open, make sure that you have a phone inside your vehicle, make sure that you travel at a safe speed. Just because the posted speed limit says one thing, one number, doesn't mean that we have to do that.
Eric, can I emphasize a little bit of the bridges? That's where most of our problems seem like today.
That's correct. We all know that, and we have signs posted everywhere. Whenever you come across a bridge in a roadway and you have cold weather and you have wet water on the roadway, that's going to lead to it having icy conditions. So we have to be extremely cautious when we go over bridges and roadways. So when you're doing that, you know, slow your speed down, watch other vehicles that are coming towards you, try to be a defensive driver best you can, and take your time.
Yeah, better.